first time, the highest educational institution, your own school, disturbed. Came for the needs while continuing research, teaching, and the highest international standards. By now, the university has been operating like that for 104 years. So the University of Tartu builds on the legacy of Gustav Adolf and his idea to govern the provinces of the eastern coast of the Baltic Sea through smart and educated people. In 1632, Gustav II Adolf signed the decree of founding the Academia of Bartensis. And he did so on the recommendation of Johann Schulter, the state councillor, the chancellor of Oslo University, and the appointed governor general of Bohemia, Hungary, and Karelia. So the University of Tartu was the second oldest university in the Kingdom of Sweden, after Uppsala and before the Turku of Vakel. The founding of the university was not random, it was enlightened emancipation. The promotion of education was not limited to the university, but also a system of public schools was introduced to educate Lutheran pastors and school teachers, and to spread literacy. In 1684, a Swedish pastor's son, Bengt Gottfried von Sirius, established a teacher's seminary on the outskirts of Tartu. And compared to other approaches of the time, it was far more forward-looking and innovative way of governance. Indeed, Estonia, Latvia, Lithuania, Finland, which Swedish 20th century geographer Sten Tegnér and the professor of economic geography from the University of Tartu, Edgar Kant, they called the Bartoscandia, along with the Scandinavian countries. Well, Estonia desired to use the idea of Bartoscandia to emphasize our illusions, inclusions in the Scandinavian culture, and thereby identify itself with the Nordic values. It proved successful, although a small nation. We have well-functioning higher education, an active language and intellectual life, vibrant economy, and a close overseas relationship. Many large nations do not have a native language university or independent statehood. This unfortunate correlation gives food for many thoughts. We're proud and happy that it is different. Our folklore remembers good old Swedish times as the golden era. A fine example are some 100 or so old trees still growing here. And according to our legends, half of those were planted by Garrett the 12th, who, so legend implies, probably had a spade on his head instead of sword. Unfortunately, the Great Northern War cut through the Swedish Estonian ties, and the people were thrown into the darkness of serfdom. The Moscovites bombed Tartu to the ground in 1704, the kind of destruction they and other foreign powers have repeated throughout the history. The poet Björk writes in her novel, The Beauty of History, which is by the way, also available in Swedish. I quote, "In the dead silence of the night, countries and people are moving from west to east, so that not even the door barks." The 24th of February 2022 made it clear that we are once again faced with a need to protect the border between West and East, the light and the darkness. Since Estonia became independent in 1918, so we have fulfilled that mission and consistently broken the dead silence of the night. Estonia has remained a realist, identifying threats from the east and disrupting the comfortable state of oblivion in the west. Today, the west has woken up 100 years after the university was founded and 105 years after the independent state of Estonia was established. We stand side by side as the European Union and NATO allies, rigid and vigorous in defense of our values on the Eastern Balkans. The word of values grounded in university education is the strongest and the most durable shield. Estonia is grateful to Sweden for the free Estonian coastal Swedes, for help in rebuilding our state, for accepting Estonian refugees of war, and supporting their free cultural life. We can well remember that, for example, in the 1950s, the more Western literature was published in Sweden than in Estonia. Well, the Estonian diaspora also had Sweden something to return. After all, the poet Ilmar Raud is considered an important promoter of surrealism in Sweden, or maybe you have heard the symphonies by Peter Tobin, who lived in Stockholm. Perhaps Ilon Wikland's illustrations have helped expand your imagination. Now it is our turn to support Ukrainian refugees waiting for our protection and the Ukrainian state defending its independence. It is an honor to do it together with Sweden as allies. The University of Tartu stands on a solid foundation, so we have reason to rank among the world's top 250 universities and are fast approaching our partners in Sweden and elsewhere. So we are among the top 1% of the world's most cited universities. Our work and activities are closely interweaved with international research centers. Our researchers regularly work in the laboratories with the research groups of Uppsala, Karolinska, Kutepu, Malmö, Lund, Stockholm, and other Swedish universities. And Swedish colleagues often visit also our university. So we are making joint efforts to grow, push the frontiers of knowledge in all critical areas of life, including, but not limited to, biodiversity, climate, and sustainable development, and also health, population, technology, IT, AI. Besides this role, Tartu also needs to assure that the interest in the Estonian state and society are also served, and that our language and culture, our way of life, they will survive. One hallmark of this role is the University of Tartu's presence in Narva with its scholarship. just 350 meters from the border of the Russian Federation. Symbolically standing for education, culture, and Western values, and against the irrational dead end of power on the opposite side of the Narva. Our university ensures that the state of Estonia and Europe have the necessary resources to keep this border permanent. This task was engraved to our DNA in 1632 by King Gustav II of Sweden, and this border has survived over time.